Thank you. After decades of hard work, experimenting, and prototyping, I achieved a great progress in crystal engineering, and it clearly became one of my many expertise. This was the time she first appeared to me. At that moment, I realized that I was never really alone. The strange sense of being watched I used to feel was probably her. She introduced herself as the warden of this world. What a miserable lie it was. She had no right to claim such a title. She was convinced that if I stayed, I would soon reach a point upon which I would no longer be myself. I couldn't understand her point. Although she tried to convince me to leave the island, I did not listen. I knew that the knowledge I gained could have changed my entire civilization for the better. The gateway was fully operational at the time. But I didn't know for sure whether I'd be able to find Quirn again. It took me 14 years to locate this world. I couldn't take the risk. I wasn't ready to leave all my work behind. Not yet. By now, it must be obvious to you that I connected these marked doors and entrances to the main energy converter unit. Actually, this feature has nothing to do with the crystal battery machine's main purpose at all. I've implemented this secondary function in order to direct you along the path and prevent you from spoiling my well-structured course. When the converter is fully powered, meaning that all the batteries are in place, it supplies energy to the mechanics. I can only hope that she will not interfere with our work. She's but a desperate echo of a fallen civilization lingering here, agelessly. It is clear that she is not worthy of the gift that has been given to her.